This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. As we approach the one-year anniversary of one of the largest and worst environmental disasters in U.S. history, we're joined by Chris Choy, who was one of the men who escaped the Deepwater Horizon oil rig in the Gulf of Mexico.
People were going crazy. There was people jumping off the rig, people holding people back from jumping off the rig, people just scrambling to get in the lifeboats. Everybody, a bunch of people were yelling, you know, we got to get out of here, the derrick's going to fall.
Thanks for being with us.
Yeah, how are you doing?
Good. Chris, I know that you're sitting next to your wife, Monica, as well as your lawyer, Steve Gordon. Chris, I just want to know now, in this entire year, that as time has passed, what's it been like?
It's been hard. It's been stressful on my marriage. It's been stressful on my family. It's just been a completely different change in my way of life.
Monica, I would imagine that no one knows him better than you do. If you could try and let folks know, what's he dealing with on a daily basis? I know last year when we spoke, he essentially had all the signs and symptoms of post-traumatic stress disorder.
He's been, we have our good days and we have bad. It's just really, he's just become a totally different person. It's just a whole new, I don't know how to exactly explain it. There's no really word to explain it, but it's definitely been different. I mean, every day is a new day.
So, Monica, is it something that do you see improvement?
Some days I do, but some days it's kind of the norm. I'm not sure the exact word how to express it. I don't know.
Chris, what's been the most challenging part? Is it dealing with the medical bills? What's that situation like? How's your health?
They have me on a few different kinds of meds, and I'm going to therapy and seeing psychiatrists. And things seem to be improving slowly, but I can tell that my attitude is different than it used to be, and yeah, it's a lot more difficult for me to concentrate and stay on task than it ever has been.
Steve, you've been representing Chris and others. Tell us, kind of bring us up to speed on what's the legal status of the rig workers and any kind of recompensation?
Well, Christopher's case was filed in the very, very early beginning. I think it was around April 24th. And since then, due to some legal maneuvering by BP and Cameron, the manufacturer of the BOP, we've never been able to take one deposition, never been able to send and get an answer to one written question. And they've maneuvered not just Christopher's case, but every case in the United States into New Orleans federal court, and basically tied our hands. Now that's okay, because it's a rather large case and we expected some of that. But in December 15th, they cut him off salary-wise. So he's had no income whatsoever since December 15th. Monica works very, very, very hard, but obviously Monica's wages aren't what Christopher's was. And so Chris is not alone. There are other people out there like this. We do anticipate, hopefully, some closure in 2012. But, you know, it's just on the legal side, I got to tell you that Transocean and BP and Halliburton all say they want to take care of these people, but then file things that are completely opposite of that.
So, Steve, for folks that might not be paying very close attention to this, are you essentially saying that the lawsuits for the rig workers are now in the same queue or same line as everybody else who's got claims against BP?
Absolutely, and that's the tragedy of it. The Exxon Valdez case took about 20 years to ultimately conclude. And so what they did was, their plan was to take these people, as well as the people, 11 families who died, and lump them in to, for instance, the fishermen's claims, somebody might own a dock that had oil on it, all of those claims, thousands and thousands of claims, and these 60 people that got hurt that night are in that mess. and we're just fighting desperately to get out. Interestingly, there are some lawyers on the plaintiff side who don't want us out because it has to do with fees and stuff like that. So they kind of want to keep us there. But really the law, and I know this judge, and he's a very fair judge, and someday he's going to address Christopher's claim, and he's going to say that you have a right to go to state court where you started. And I have a feeling that when we get to Texas state court, justice will be served.
So, Christopher, a final thought from you. You've been facing these health challenges. There are these financial and legal challenges out there. What are you hoping for as an outcome?
I didn't do this so much for, you know, the financial purpose and stuff like that. It's more of I just want to make sure my family's taken care of. And if it, you know, I lost my way of making a living when this happened because there's, I can't go back onto a rig. And there's just no way I can make the same amount of money I was out there to provide for my family like I could. I can't make that now. And I just want to make sure my family's taken care of.
All right, Christopher and Monica Choy, we wish you the best. And Steve Gordon, thanks for being with us. This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.